Hey guys, how's it going? So, the last days, or longer than days, I worked on a little apartment complex. And I call it District 7, and it's right here. So this will probably be more than one video. There are three floors, the bottom floor, first floor, second floor, and so far and so go. And I think to get like these sweet 5-minute videos and also give me some time to work on the next project, I will cut these videos in different parts. Let's see how it goes. So District 7 is pretty much just you pay some money and have this little extra area that is, well, you could say protected. Everybody else, I mean, you could just go in, but you are in your little community, say, other than just having a shack outside that is really open visually. So I first placed down this elevator, and the main objective was to just build around the thing. And for now we're going with the first floor, and I pretty much say we start with the most easiest one, which is this one, which is still for rent. And besides that it's laggy, that's probably the reason nobody wants it. It's it's nothing. Like it looks like the last person who lived here just throw some stuff in here, but never cleaned up and then got out, so it's nothing special. So we can always stop with this one. But let's go to a place that's way more interesting. And this one is way more colorful and had way more fun with this one. So I tried to pretty much structure some rooms after some of the raiders we got with Nuka-Cola DLC. And I can't remember how the name of these raiders were. I always forgot their names. But I'm pretty sure you know which one are these. And yeah, I just pretty much made a combination from some university or high school room, combining with just a bunch of psychopaths. And yeah, you have some interesting stuff around here. The next one is this one, which has this little camera out here. So our resident is maybe a little bit suspicious. Oh, and I really love this so much. I think it's from the USO mod. I can't remember. And yeah, I had a lot of fun with this one. It's just a survivor home who pretty much has everything to don't leave the room. You have this little bathrooms. Some of these apartments here have bathrooms. Some don't have one. Some using the bathhouse. Some just doing things I don't want to talk about. And some have bathrooms. It's pretty much like most of these rooms are just empty, and you have to get your stuff, your furniture, your utilities. You have to get everything. So makes sense that some people have bathrooms, some people don't have. But this person got a lot of good stuff. Like he went wild. Yeah, he has a really nice apartment. It's a little cramped, but it's enough. He has what he needs. But he has even more, because you have the secret door. It looks like this guy has some interesting stuff going on. And yes, these surveillance monitors, all these monitors, I got this idea from ex-Donald Strong. Donald Strong is no longer a thing. Now it's Strong Swanson or something. I think that's his new name. I can't remember. But yeah, I got this from his Batman build, and I found it was... I think it was so cool, so I had to do it myself, but of course more, well, rusty. And yeah, you have this little workbench where he builds this crazy weapon. I don't know, man, I think it will definitely explode if you fire this. And yeah, I have some makeshift power armor. Sawblade. Maybe he wants to go in the arena with this. I would love to see this power armor fight in the arena. And yeah, the last room we're gonna look at is pretty simple. Nothing too special. I said beside raider stuff and maybe some secrets, I build a lot of just simple rooms. Maybe I thought about like a mother and a child or something. Like, it's really nothing too special. It's just trying to live the best life. And you also have a little bathroom. So yeah, that's it with the first floor, or like the ground floor of our apartment complex. We're gonna take a look at the other two floors in two other videos, because I think they will be too long. And yeah, I'm making good progress in this town. And how you notice and how I said a lot, the frame rate gets really chunky, so I'm happy to finish the main like living and commercial district over here, and just have to go to the smaller caves, which I hopefully have no longer FPS problems, because all the stuff is no longer visible and I can do more of the industrial stuff and the farming stuff. Like the mushroom farm. But yeah, I'm gonna have a lot of fun with this. But yeah, we are not so far away from finishing Trash Town. Of course, the brother still needs to be finished. I am still working on this, because I pretty much destroyed everything and then just tried to rebuild it. At the moment, it's just completely empty, so... Yeah, but yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you do, please leave a like and consider subscribing to be part of the Trash Gang. Bye.